Hey, I'm David and this is Art Alerts. Today I have an exciting unboxing for you. Today the unboxing is by Dan Lam. I first started collecting works by Dan Lam in January 2017. She's mainly known for her spiky blobs, but since then she's created a whole host of other sort of material-based gloopy-like figures. It popped off on Instagram really, really early when the art game was just sort of taking off there, and I've always really, really loved her work. About once a year, she does a minis release where she puts out smaller versions of her sculptures that you can collect. Some of them hang off the side of a shelf, others are sort of free-form standing. I don't have any of the free-form standing work, so I was really excited to collect them. She does the drop in two parts. There's a collector-based drop for one day, and then she adds more for a more public release. If you're interested in her releases, definitely sign up for her listserv. I really, really love her work, and I'm sure the editor will cut in my collection that I've already collected from her. But let's open these up and check out the new ones that I got. Her mini releases sell out super quickly, so you'll have to be fast if you want to get one. This time around, I ended up getting two sort of hanging pieces off of a shelf, and then also two pieces that are freestanding. So I'm not sure which is in which box, but we'll check it out. We got the little receipt. Ooh, it looks like it came with little certificates of authenticity. I'll show this off real quick. Pretty cool. And she also included some stickers. These stickers are fantastic. Hell yeah. Thank you so much for the stickers. Let's see what's in this box. Looks like these are the little shelf pieces. We'll set this aside. Again, more stickers, and then also some more certificates of authenticity. So I got four total, so I got four little certificates. And I think these are the freestanding pieces. So she started with more of the wall hanging pieces, so why don't we open up those first? Wow, so here they are. Looks great. I always opt for the super colorful ones. They're actually pretty sturdy, so even if you drop them like I just did, she sort of coated them in a resin to make them pretty durable, so even if they fall off the shelf, I think they'll be fine. You don't want to test them too hard, but I sort of love the way there's the ombre of different colors and the spiky sort of color that sort of sets it apart, adds like a little bit of contrast there. Excited to put these on my shelf. And then I've never had the freestanding version, so I was super excited to collect these. I actually collected the shelf pieces first because I thought these had all sold out, and then the next day I was more on top of it and I was able to get these guys. So look at that. Just love this. It can just sit on the shelf. One more. I like this one a lot too. So yeah, super cool. Dan Lam shows with Hashimoto sometimes. That's how I originally collected the minis. I think they were released at Art Basel, and I was able to get a few. So yeah, thank you so much, Dan Lam, for these. I think they're so good. Obviously, I really like the spiky ones, but she does some without spikes as well. I think the spikes are just so iconic. I don't normally collect some like more abstracted work like this, but I think these are just so fun, so colorful, and they kind of create their own forms that are instantly recognizable. Recently, other artists have sort of copied this drip-like technique, and when I saw that, I immediately thought of Dan Lam and thought, damn, I can't believe they're copying her. But maybe it's just a coincidence, who knows? That happens sometimes in the art game. So again, thank you so much, Dan Lam, for these pieces. I love collecting your minis. They're so easy to collect, and it's such like a fun little project you do every year. She ends up releasing something like 1,200 of them, and they all sell out, which is super admirable, just watching an artist sort of find success in this area. Although they're all editioned, each one itself is unique. You can find sort of like different colorways repeated, but none of the shapes are exactly alike because of the way they're made. I think they all turn out so cool. I'm excited to display them on my shelf back here. And yeah, have a good one. Thanks for watching.